This week I will have less time for work. Everyone got ill at home, so I stayed a few days to care for my wife and children. In the meantime, I did some editing for my podcast trailer. It was fun, but it is a blessing to work with watercolor today. There are no cables, no software. It's just me with a brush, water, paper, and imagination. Well, this morning I decided again to do another Royal Concerthall watercolor. It's my fourth watercolor from this building this winter. And there are three reasons for that. Well, the first reason is that this scene is amazing. I like this long street with this light effect, with long shadows, people, cars, bicycles, and then the old classic building behind it. But another reason is that, and I told that in another video, that when you paint such a cityscape with hard backlight, you lose a lot of color. And I think that's the reason that I choose this scene after it, because this is a same light effect, but still I'm using a lot of color in it. Because I used my own photograph for it, and when I'm making pictures in town with this light, I know what to do. Because I know its effect, that you lose a lot of strong color with this light effect. But for this painting, I'm using some pictures the client sent me, and normally I don't do that. But these pictures are very good, so I wanted to give it a try. But after three watercolors, I noticed that it's quite hard to find my own colors and my own contrast in his pictures. Another reason is that he uses another camera than I do, and the perspective, the lines were strange in these pictures. They were not realistic. In a picture that I look normal, but when you are painting it, like in this first one, this is too hard. This is too much. When you are standing there on the spot with your easel, you won't make it that in this directions. So I made a sketch this morning, and I decided to keep the lines more, well, straight towards a point further away. So the perspective is not that extreme now. I discovered a big mistake this morning. I feel really ashamed. I put the watercolor upside down. And then I had more focus on the foreground, the lighter part on the street, and the shadows over there, of course, they must have all the same direction. But the long shadow under the bus stop has a different direction than the others. And that's stupid. I can't believe I did it. And I can't believe I discovered it now, this morning. So I already washed it a bit away, but I really have to do it with more water. And perhaps this whole part must done over again, I'm afraid. This is a consequence of working from several pictures. Then you're focused on an object, and sometimes you forget to see an overall view, you know. These are the moments I'm so glad working behind the scenes as a painter. This is definitely a stupid mistake, and I must not think about this going wrong on stage, for example. Fortunately, I'm not working on stage. I'm a happy artist alone in my studio. And please don't tell anyone about that wrong shadow we saw under the bus stop.